In 1618, the Thirty Years' War erupted in Europe and became one of the most destructive conflicts in European history. Ending in 1648, the war was fought primarily in what is now Germany, and at various points involved most of the countries of Europe. Originating from the rise of the Reformation and the conflict between Protestants and Catholics, the war caused extensive destruction of entire regions and cities, the collapse of economies, and the depopulation of numerous countries, including Germany. The conflict caused widespread episodes of famine and disease, while bankrupting most of the European countries, and marked the end of religious ideologies as the European political power structure. Born into a devastated Europe on the brink of collapse in 1646, Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz was considered the most important logician between Aristotle and George Boole in 1847, and would come to lay the foundations for logical computation, automated calculations, binary language, and artificial intelligence. Described as one of the most imposing figures in Western thought, Leibniz published papers on law, economics, politics, theology, chemistry, physics, and architecture. However, it would be his work in philosophy and mathematics that would establish his place in history. As a German native, Leibniz grew up seeing the destructive power of war and disagreement firsthand, and his work was strongly influenced by effects of the Thirty Years' War. Leibniz had an idealistic vision that all disputes and arguments could be logically broken down to find a peaceful solution. He thought that language was too vague, and that misunderstanding was at the root of all arguments and even war. He concluded that language must become as clear and precise as mathematics. To do this, he reasoned that all terms of a discourse must be clearly defined, and that by using a symbolic language to represent ideas, you could ultimately calculate someone's argument. From this, he developed calculus ratiocinator, a framework of symbolic logic that could make calculations of a concept or an argument feasible. Leibniz suggested that the process of reasoning could be broken down into smaller and smaller elements until you finally reach the building blocks of thought. For example, man is a complex concept defined by other concepts. Animal is another concept that is used to define the term man. Animal, in turn, is defined as a living thing, which is defined by yet more concepts. This led Leibniz down a grander path to his end goal to develop a universal language composed of symbols that could be used to represent human thought. Alongside his philosophical work, Leibniz had many accomplishments, including developing infinitesimal calculus independently of Isaac Newton, and inventing the Leibniz wheel, which is the engine of mechanical calculators used up until the mid-1970s. Leibniz tried to take the mechanical calculator one step further by developing a reasoning machine that does automatic thought that he never completed. His work wouldn't be looked at until a few hundred years later in the 1950s with the emergence of a new field, artificial intelligence. Leibniz also refined the binary system to how we use it today, which is the foundation of all digital computers. The work of Leibniz laid the foundation for modern logic and analytic philosophy. He made major contributions to physics and technology, and anticipated notions that surface much later in biology, medicine, geology, architecture, psychology, linguistics, cybernetics, artificial intelligence, and information science. But maybe most revolutionary of all, he gave us the idea and the foundation to create a machine with the ability to reason.